This video contains Forensic Science Instrumentation Techniques Part 5, written by Yukta Guglot, Secretary of Applied Forensic Research Sciences, presented by Ritoza Das, Volunteer of Applied Forensic Research Sciences. Topic: Introduction to Microscope, Part 2. Contents of this video are Anatomy of Microscope and Significance of Microscope. This is the diagram of a microscope with all its parts labeled. Parts of microscope. Number 1. The eyepiece or ocular. The specimen is viewed through the eyepiece. Typically, standard eyepieces have a magnifying power of 10x. Optional eyepieces of varying powers are available, typically from 5x to 30x. Number 2. Eyepiece tube. It holds the eyepieces in place above the objective lens. Binocular microscope heads typically incorporate a diopter adjustment ring that allows for the possible inconsistencies of our eyesight in one or both eyes. Number 3. Objective lens. These are the primary optical lenses on a microscope. They almost always consist of 4x, 10x, 40x and 100x powers. When coupled with a 10x, most common eyepiece lens, total magnification is 40x, 4x times 10x, 100x, 400x and 1000x, and typically include 3, 4 or 5 on lenses on most microscopes. Objectives can be forward or rear facing. Number 4. Nosepiece. It is also known as the revolving turret. It holds the objective lenses. It is immovable. Hence, it can revolve the objective lenses depending on the magnification power of the lens. Number 5. The adjustment knobs or coarse knobs. These knobs are used to focus the microscope. There are two types of adjustment knobs, that is fine adjustment knobs and coarse adjustment knobs. Number 6. Stage and stage clips. This is the section on which the specimen is placed for viewing. They have stage clips hold the specimen slides in place. The most common stage is a mechanical stage which allows the control of the slides by moving the slides using the mechanical knobs on the stage instead of moving it manually. Stage clips are used when there is no mechanical stage. The viewer is required to move the slide manually to view different sections of the specimen. Number 7. Iris diaphragm. It controls the amount of light reaching the specimen. It is located above the condenser and below the stage. Most high quality microscopes include an Abbe condenser with an iris diaphragm. Combined, they control both the focus and quantity of light applied to the specimen. Number 8. Aperture. This is a hole on the microscope stage through which the transmitted light from the source reaches the stage. Number 9. Microscope illuminator. This is the microscope's light source located at the base. It is used instead of a mirror. It captures light from an external source of a low voltage of around 100 volts. Number 10. Condenser. The condenser lens works with the diaphragm to focus the intensity of the light source onto the slide containing the specimen. These parts are located under the microscope stage. Now let's talk about the significance of microscope in forensic science. Microscope analysis and examination of evidence provide valuable results in crime scene or scene of crime investigation. The following evidence is examined under a microscope. Number 1. Gunshot residue analysis. Number 2. Firearms identification, bullet mark comparison. Number 3. Identification or investigation of gemstones and jewelry. Number 4. Examination of paint particles and fiber. Number 5. Handwriting and print examination or forgery examination. Number 6. Counterfeit banknotes. Number 7. Trace comparison. And number 8. Biological and serological evidence examination. With this, we come to an end of the video. Thank you.